Welcome back to the Reflactor channel. You know, it's been a few weeks since I released the first video on Astrohopper, and that's this new app that runs on your smartphone, and it turns this into a precision telescope pointing device. Now, over the past few weeks, I've had a lot of suggestions and ideas sent to me by viewers just like yourself. Thank you, I appreciate that. And so I've taken more time to experiment with Astrohopper. In this video, I'm going to list the top 5 tips for using Astrohopper. I'm going to include a bonus near the end, and then at the very end, I'm going to show you an event that happened while I was recording this video, and it's a very, very strange coincidence. Anyways, stay tuned. If you haven't watched the first Astrohopper video, I'll put a link to it down in the description box. If you go to the trouble to print out one of these 3D printed platforms to set your smartphone on, please do not leave it attached to your telescope when it's not in use. That's right, don't be a dummy like me and leave it attached to your telescope in the Texas heat in your car for 2 days, because look what it did to this thing. It bent it like a pretzel. Despite having relatively low tension from the rubber bands that held this onto the telescope, because of the supernova-like temperatures inside my Honda, well, that just stretched this out over a couple of days, and this one's pretty ruined. The good news is, I have a backup. If you want to print one of these 3D printable platforms, the file is still available from Thingiverse. It's totally free, and I put the link down in the description box. Ignore what I said in the first video about Astrohopper regarding how to attach your smartphone case to the telescope using magnets. I had seen photos of people that would basically take a secondary case and put a magnet on it, either glue it or use double-sided sticky tape. As it turns out, unless you have a really high-quality magnetometer compass sensor in your smartphone, that magnet is actually just going to mess with your compass sensor and make Astrohopper even harder to use. So don't use magnets at all. And that actually brings me to number 3. Instead, try using self-adhesive Velcro strips. You can buy it here. It's actually hooked together. This side has hooks. This side has the non-hook side. You can split this apart. And this is actually just split apart like that. And so you take this off, you glue one side to your case. You take this off and you glue that to your telescope. You can buy this stuff really cheap on Amazon. In fact, I've provided an affiliate link in the description box below. Using that link costs you nothing extra, but it does help the channel a little bit. If you're liking the content of this video so far, please boop that like button. Please! For number 4, let's go over to the workbench. Most modern smartphones have a compass built in. But did you know that technically you don't even need the compass to use Astrohopper? After diving into the nitty-gritty of how this works, Astrohopper is even more impressive. The compass is only used at the very start of your viewing session to get you to a point where you can do your first alignment. And after you do your first alignment, Astrohopper ignores the compass completely and instead uses a precision gyro sensor, integrating in real time to determine your angle. Think of it as using an inertial navigation system. If your screen goes to sleep, though, it will start back up with the compass, waiting for you to do that first alignment. This is why you should always make your screen timeout as long as possible when using Astrohopper. If you have an Apple device, the developer of Astrohopper, Mr. Bayless, has provided very detailed instructions just for you. Go to the Astrohopper website, I've put a link in the description box below, and click on the question mark. Then click on the link for the iOS special instructions. Now, I haven't tried this yet, but a very clever viewer named Carolyn sent in some photos that shows an awesome new optional way to attach your smartphone to your telescope, and that is the use of double-sided suction cups. You can see them here. You can pick up an entire package of these. I think there's 20 of them in a package for less than $6 on Amazon. I've put an affiliate link down in the description box. To be honest, I didn't even know that double-sided suction cups even existed, but from what I've heard, they work very well.
Hello? Hi, yes.
Hi, I apologize. My phone is getting bad reception. Who is this? From Orion? While I was recording this video, I got a phone call from Orion Technical Support. You may remember a previous video I did about the scariest error message you can get on a go-to telescope. Well, I took that broken handset and I followed their advice and I mailed it out to their headquarters out in Watsonville, California. And they said they would evaluate it and see if there was something that they could fix rather cheaply. Maybe it was something super easy. Unfortunately, they weren't able to fix it. But the good news is I already obtained a replacement hand controller and that fixed the problem. I will say I was actually pleasantly surprised that their technical support called me. And you know, in the few times that I've spoken with them on the phone, they've always been very professional. Every time I use AstroHopper, I get more and more impressed. It's really a good tool to use, especially if your budget is zero. Now, if you enjoyed this video, you might want to try looking at these two videos. They're pretty intriguing too. So, please like and subscribe. Clear skies, everybody.